Greetings, folks. I'm Sheikh Jalal Ahmed from Fat Cab Motorsports. And I just got these Ohlins DFV dampers from my customer Murat, who just put on his FCM Elite optimized H&R coilovers, which I've made a few videos about. You can check the cards at the upper right for those for references to that. And the rear was, well, it's definitely jacking down. It's almost, not quite 2-to-1. The gas force in the rear is 62 pounds. I'll make a video about that. But the front here is very interesting because I've got the damper at full, almost full droop. I just inserted it like a millimeter. And from where I've inserted it to where the bump stop engages, which the bump stop actually comes into play in less than 2 inches of travel. So there's, it's, my guess is it's fairly long. It might be at least 60 millimeters. I haven't taken this apart. I don't actually plan on taking it apart. So from here, boom. So that's the point at which the bump stop engages. And I think this should just be a little. So from, it's just about less than a quarter inch. So yeah, it's less than 2 inches of travel. Because right at the 2 inch, I mean, if I just barely insert it just a tiny bit, just so it's not running up against the metal droop stop. Now I'm going to run it on the show live screen. So it's already, it's definitely touching, and I'll show you here on the screen here. So, see this here. Eliminate some shaky cam, hopefully. Yeah. So there's our current dyno result. And that spike that you see is the bump stop. Because it's going in compression, and then as it's reaching the end of its travel, the force is increasing as the bump stop is coming into play. I'm actually just gonna run it through. I will do a save. You can see it, and front gas force is about 40 pounds, which is not too bad. I mean, it could be a little softer, in my opinion. So you can see it's actually digressing a little earlier than the rear. The rear is the fuchsia curve. So these coilovers were designed to be run with, I think it was an 80 newton per millimeter front and a 70 rear. I think I have that backwards. But essentially, it's clearly designed to really run on the bump stops. And I'm not sure how low he has this set, but there's not a ton of travel. And he actually went to a softer spring before he ended up switching to ours. So I'll go ahead and save this as a separate test, but I just wanted to show that the bump stop contact, so I can't even really run the dyno in place with the whole, this is with the strut assembly together, the strut insert and the strut together. So it's just, there's not a ton of travel up front. They want you to use that bump stop. All right, take care.